Yesterday, after the damage report ended, Trump did indeed get impeached for the second time. It did happen. It was the most bipartisan impeachment in the history of the United States. 10 Republicans signing on, which is good. 95% of them didn't, which is bad. So, you know, you take your good with your bad. While all that was going on, though, we're now getting a little bit of information about how Trump has been processing all this, both the impeachment that happened, who defended him, who didn't, and also the lingering conversations about his culpability with the violence that happened just a little bit more than a week ago. And so yesterday, again, after the show, he released a video condemning violence. We're gonna show you a small portion of that here.
I wanna be very clear. I unequivocally condemn the violence that we saw last week. Violence and vandalism have absolutely no place in our country and no place in our movement. Making America great again has always been about defending the rule of law, supporting the men and women of law enforcement, and upholding our nation's most sacred traditions and values. Mob violence goes against everything I believe in and everything our movement stands for. No true supporter of mine could ever endorse political violence. No true supporter of mine could ever disrespect law enforcement or our great American flag. No true supporter of mine could ever threaten or harass their fellow Americans. If you do any of these things, you are not supporting our movement, you are attacking it, and you are attacking our country. We cannot tolerate it.
Okay. So no, making America great again was always about blah, blah, nonviolent stuff. Anyone, no true supporter of his could ever endorse violence. Aida, what'd you think?
I think Malcolm X was the one who said the chickens always come home to roost. I think that, you know, it's interesting to watch this because it's done, buddy. It's done. These people are so far gone at this point. There's a mass hysteria upon us. So that's not gonna resonate with them. That's not gonna resonate with them. And now that all of this damage is done and you realize the stain that you are on this country and its history, you know, it's appalling to hear that at this point because you have endorsed violence against Hillary Clinton, Ilhan Omar. You know, it's just been constant. So I would be pissed if I was his people, his base. I would be like, oh yeah, now you wanna back out on us? That's how I feel. I would be like, really? That's what we doing? Now you trying to back away from us? You have constantly been, you know, you've been blowing this whistle for years now. And you've been calling on violence since you asked for the murders of the young men of the exonerated five. You've been asking for violence since then and possibly before. And now you want to say you want to back away from it? I think it's cowardly and is disgraceful at this point.
Yeah, it's like I said on the Young Turks yesterday, if he had been saying stuff like this from day one,
yep.
Good. But like at a certain point, it seems more like you're covering your ass. And it doesn't mean that it's not in some way good. Him releasing the video like that, even though it lies about what MAGA is and everything, like there's a lot of lies. But you know, it's Trump. What can we expect? Is better than him not releasing it, maybe. And it's better than him continuing to call for violence, but it's way, way, way too late. On another level, we know that he doesn't actually believe it. So I guess he gets some credit in theory if it stops some of his followers from continuing to be violent, but I doubt that it can because of all of his past comments. I think that Aida is 100% right about that. For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.